Hey there, everybody. I just wanted to quickly just hop on. You can see Tower One just behind me here. This is Lower Manhattan. It's actually this little marina just here. It's a beautiful boat sitting right beside me across the river. So I've never seen it for a boat, but I wanted to very quickly, a little bit windy here, so I apologize for any wind that's happening. It's a beautiful sunny day here in New York. I don't know if you can see just in the background there, we have the grand lady there. There's the Statue of Liberty, Ellis Island over there, back to Manhattan, back to town. So I want to talk a little bit about the agency business, because I made the mistake of, whilst I was walking around enjoying my Sunday morning, or Sunday afternoon I should say, that I was just reading a couple of posts of people who, I guess, trying to tell people that all you need to do is go and sell some clients in this game, and it's really easy to make money in this business of the agency world, and you can get a bucket load of leads without really any effort, and you don't need to prospect, you don't need to send out emails, you don't need to pick up the phone, you don't need to advertise, you don't need to do anything, and miraculously clients are going to just put money in your bank account. And I just want to call out what that is, and that's just bullshit. Anybody that tells you you don't need to market to go and get clients, or you don't need to physically engage customers that will invest money in your marketing ideas, or your Facebook or ad agency or funnel business, anybody that tells you any hard work or any work at all, that the client is miraculously going to pay you tens of thousands of dollars without you explaining yourself, proving that you can do the work, showing them or demonstrating to them that you're capable, or that you're qualified, or that you have the ability to deliver a result. Anybody that is saying those things is lying to you. Those people have never been in their own agency business. In most cases, these people have tried to start something, they figured out how hard it was, and they decided to get into coaching. And so none of these people will put their money where their mouth is, and none of these people are telling you the truth. And so I get really annoyed when people say, well, you can just, you know, snap your fingers and customers. Well, I'm going to tell you that that's never been the case, and never been the story of how to create an agency business. So here's the thing, you've got to work hard, and the key things that you have to have, you don't need a lot of clients to generate a level of revenue in your business. You don't. And you can generate good money in this business. But if you're only interested in making the money out of this business, you will fail. You might make some money, but you're going to get clients who are going to leave you. You're going to get clients that will badmouth you. You're going to get clients that will sue you. You'll get clients that will take you to task because you have made promises to them that you didn't deliver on, or you undervalued, or you didn't set the right expectations with clients. Now, I don't want this conversation to be a downer, but I just want to be very, very clear that if you really want to do well in this business, you actually got to care about this business. You got to care about delivering a great result for your clients. You got to care about what you do. You got to master your skills to help your clients get results, because that's what they're going to spend money on. That's what they're going to stay with you for, and that's what they're going to introduce you to new clients as well as along the way. So is this business simple? There is some simple processes in this business that you need to be following. One, you've got to have an offer. If you haven't got an offer out there, or you're unclear about the offer that you're making, then that's not going to help anybody. That's not going to help you, and that's not going to help the client. Number two, you need to understand who's going to benefit from the offer you're making. So the frame of reference is, does Facebook advertising work for a lot of industries? Absolutely. Does it work for every industry? Absolutely not. So you've got to understand where your market is, and where it markets, and where your market's customers are. So you also want to align the channels that you use to promote their services with their opportunities. You can't push shit uphill trying to make something work. You've got to have something that has the best possible chance of getting a result. So the clear thing here is, in your offering, you need to understand your clients, or your prospective clients' business, how they do business, how they generate customers, where they generate their customers from, how their customers buy, what are their pain points, what are they missing, and how do you help solve that problem. So the first thing is you want to be super clear about what you're offering and also the result that you believe you can get for the client based on the offer that you make to the market. So you've also got to have some level of clarity that you're going to get a result for a client, because if you can't get results for clients, then you're going to have to go back to the drawing board and figure it out. The next thing is that you want to be consistent in generating clients. You want to be talking to people. You're in business. You're building a brand, an asset. That means that you need to treat your business, your entity, like a real business. I cannot believe how many people out there in the marketplace don't have registered business. I cannot believe how many people in this agency game don't have errors and omissions insurance to protect themselves against liabilities that they create in advertising and marketing. I cannot believe how many people do business with people without an agreement, without actually having a signed agreement. These are things that will put your business and you and your personal livelihood at risk, because if you mess it up and a client decides to take you to task, you could lose everything. So if you don't have a clear agreement that outlines the terms and conditions of what your deliverables are and what your expectations are in terms of what you do, then you're putting yourself at risk. If you don't have errors and omissions insurance to protect you from liability being sued by customers, and let me tell you, thousands of lawsuits against marketing companies are happening every year. So don't think that it will never happen to you. It can happen to you, right? So understand that you want to protect yourself and protect your asset, which is you, your liabilities. So you must have, or I would encourage you, you don't have to, but I would encourage you to go and find out get some errors and omissions insurance so that you're protected. And if a client knows that you're protected, it means that they will treat you as a professional business, because you've taken care of some very fundamental compliance things. Have a registered business, have an entity. I would highly recommend that you speak to your accountant to understand how you can set up the structure for your business. These are not very expensive things. They don't take a long time, but they're things that you need to put into place so that you protect yourself in this business. So having a clear offer, having a real asset, a real business, having some of the compliance things that you need to make sure that you protect your business, really important, right? Next, a sales process. You're going to have to talk to customers. If you want customers to spend thousands of dollars with you, they are not going to buy your stuff at the click of a button. So you must develop a sales process. You must understand to do an analysis or a diagnosis or offer the ability so the customer understands how you help them. So you've got to assess their problems, their objectives. You've got to assess their reasonings to why it's important for them to get that started now. You've got to have a solution, understand their bottlenecks, and be the solution. So you must have a sales process. If you have a sales process, you're going to make it a lot easier for you to convert, generate sales. Lead generation, you can do, there's so many things you can do for lead generation. There are so many things that you don't have to spend money on to do lead generation, but at the end of the day, does lead generation cost you money? Yes, because it's going to cost you or someone else's time to generate those leads for you. I would highly encourage that if you're in the AdWords game, that you should be running your own AdWords campaign. Mike, one of the guys that I coach, lives in a rural regional area. He runs advertising. Google AdWords, spends a couple of $100 a week. In the last 6 weeks, generated seven clients, $800 with advertising to get seven clients. Average client is invested $2,000 a month. So that's $14,000 for $800 worth of advertising. And he's specializing in AdWords. Sorry, there's a helicopter above me, so I apologize for the background noise. So he specializes in AdWords and generates clients through AdWords. Facebook advertisers, if I look at my consulting champions, Nick, Oz, a whole bunch of them are running ads on Facebook to generate leads for their businesses, for own businesses. So if you're in Facebook advertising, you should be advertising on Facebook. This is going to help you get better at what you do, understand the mechanism, understand the flow, and you don't have to spend a lot of money to do this. But the thing is if you want to generate leads, then the fastest way to generate them is to run ads, right? Or hire or outsource your ads to somebody who can run ads for you to get consistent leads. On average, you can spend between $150 to $200 for a opportunity, for a presentation. You know, if you do five presentations, it's $1,000. If you convert that client and the minimum they spend with you is $1,500 a month, that's an $18,000 client. That is a bargain. I would pay that $1,000 every day of the week and tenfold if that was more. That's the second thing. You've got to have a consistent way of generating leads, opportunities and prospects, and you want to be able to filter those prospects as well. The third part of this process is fulfillment. Most people get caught up in the fulfillment themselves, right? If you get caught up in fulfillment, that means it's going to slow you down in being able to generate clients. What you want to do is to work with a resource partner or a white label agency that has a team that can actually do the fulfillment for you. They also have systems and processes for onboarding and client management. So this will help you leverage your opportunity and free up time for you to do the most important thing, and that is to do selling and marketing to generate clients. That's how you're going to grow this business successfully. So you need the support, you need fulfillment. If you're doing fulfillment, you're going to be the bottleneck. So you're going to end up with these up and down cycles. I know a lot of people believe they can do it better than a resource partner. Let me tell you, there's always somebody who's out there that's way better than you, and it's probably going to cost way less than the amount of time and energy it costs you to invest in delivering those services to the market. So it's really important that you get your fulfillment right. And again, going out there, are you going to make mistakes? Absolutely. I've been in this game for 27 years and I'm still making mistakes, and I know what I'm doing. I've been involved in multi-million dollar, right now a double eight figure agency, and we're making mistakes in that agency even. So does everything go smoothly? Absolutely not. However, if you're consistent and you're focused and you have a vision and you want to build a real business that is an asset, one that will support your aspirations, or two, that you might sell as an opportunity for the hard work in you building that asset into some sort of realization, then you're in the right place and you're in the right game. But understand that you have to do the work. And whatever is stopping you, whatever is holding you back, you've got to start asking questions. Reframe, because if it's fear that's holding you back from scaling or growing, and what I mean by fear, most fears are pretty irrational because there are movies that we play around in our head. There are ways to overcome that. There are ways to understand what those fears are and create a frame of reference, because let me tell you, there are people out there who have little skills but are investing in their education, their knowledge and understanding of this business, and they're out there going out there and working and generating. I find the majority of people who are in this advertising or agency game, they're playing in the agency game. They're not building an agency at all. They're just messing around. And so, as I said, this isn't easy. It's not easy. And if you think it is, then you're selling yourself an incredible lie. And if anybody tells you that this business is so simple and so easy, then understand, I would want to see their results in their business to prove that they can deliver what they say they deliver. But understand, at the end of the day, yes, can you do well in this business? Absolutely. Do you need to work very, very hard? You've got to do some work. Sometimes you're going to work really hard, sometimes you're not going to work hard at all, right? But ultimately, you're going to have to do some work in this business. And so this is the thing. What's holding you back? If you have something that's holding you back, if you have a belief that something isn't right, I'd love for you to comment below this video. I'd love to get your comments on this, because at the end of the day, one of the things that I'm here, I believe, on this planet for is to help people to solve their problems, to see a clear path for themselves, to encourage, motivate, and help you to realize your aspirations, because I know that this business, this marketing agency business, is one that is really important. There are so many aspects to this that basically deliver incredible opportunities for those who take advantage of those opportunities, but you're going to have to work for them. You're going to have to put in some effort. You're going to have to try a few things. You're going to have to get some feedback. You're going to have to fail massively. You're going to have to fail often, as I have done, and many before me who've done very well have also had to do, because you're going to have to learn. At some point, you're going to have to learn. And what you want to do is you want to build a real business that has an entity, that follows some level of compliance, that has advice. G'day, Harry. I'm not sure what niche I should choose. Harry, What I would strongly recommend you do is go and have, if you have clients already, then you know that there's a niche to go after. If you're waiting to start this business because you can't choose a niche, stop doing that. Just go and talk to business people. If you have a service that you offer, Harry, whether it's Facebook ads or AdWords, just go and offer it to businesses, right? Any, it doesn't matter. Don't get caught up in this niche bullshit, because that's just going to slow you down and that's going to hold you up. What I'd highly recommend that you do, Harry, and thank you for putting in the question here on this video, is I just encourage you to go and share with businesses what you do. That's all you got to do. Go and get your first client, or go get a client. Then when you deliver the results for that client, you'll become an expert in that niche. Then you can go to the rest of the market, and that's your niche. That's one way to find a niche, is let the niche find you, not you have to find the niche, right? And here's the other thing. Don't copy and follow other people's path in niches, right? Everybody wants to work with dentists. Everybody wants to work with financial advisors, mortgage brokers, freaking chiropractors, who else? Roofing guys, plumbing guys, all these markets. All I'm saying is, not that you don't go into those markets, but if you take an interest in their business, if you talk to people who run those types of businesses first, get an insight to what they're looking for, where their problem is, and more importantly, how you can solve that problem, then that's how you find a niche, Harry. Saying, I'm not sure what niche, fuck the niche, forget the niche, right? Forget the niche. Go and talk to businesses. The question I would ask you, Harry, is what service do you provide, right? What service do you provide? Are other people providing the same service, right? And make a list of businesses who would benefit from those services, right? Make a list of businesses who would benefit from those services. Then go, if you know somebody in those businesses, go out there and say, hey, can I just show you what's working right now to get a result? And if you teach people what you know, Harry, you're going to get a client. People will turn around and say, Harry, how can you help me? How can you help me do this? Or what's it going to cost me for you to do this for me? Right? That's how you're going to get your first client, Harry, is by just going and talk to businesses and just say, hey, think about who would benefit the most, and just reach out to some of those businesses. Hey, if I can show you a strategy on how to do this, show them how to do what you know, teach them how to do what you know, and then you can say, hey, I can either do this with you, or you can pay me to do it for you. What do you want to do? And that will open you up to generating clients. It's one of the easiest ways, Harry, to get clients. So I really appreciate you asking that question. Thank you. Thank you for doing that. So hopefully that gives you some insight. So hopefully that I haven't been too harsh in my rant here, or discouraging in any way. If anything, I want to encourage you to go out there and make it happen. But just don't believe that this business is so easy. Please don't get into this business if you think this business is just making money. If you're after the money, this is not the business to be in. Let me tell you, most people undervalue what they do. They undercharge and they get themselves in a financial trouble when they do this, right? Thank you, Harry. I really appreciate that you love my emails. So as I said, get serious. Do the work. Right, get out there and do the work. Stop listening to horseshit out there. Just go and talk to some customers. If you want some free training, some great training that's free, just go to the consultingunleashed.com website, download my free training. It'll tell you exactly what you need to do to go and get clients without you having to spend any money on me or my services. I want to encourage you to maximize your opportunity to go and build something great. So thank you for watching this video. I really appreciate you being here. Just give you one last look at the beautiful skyline, the beautiful town. I'm down here on the harbour. This is the river. We've got some boats coming out here. So I just want to say thanks and enjoy your weekend. Look forward to seeing you on other videos, and more importantly, looking forward to seeing you in some of the...